Tame Microsoft Edge, how to customize your browser. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Microsoft has gotten really pushy of late. I've talked about it in other venues with respect to Windows and OneDrive and a couple of other things. By putting what they think will be helpful in our faces, whether we want it or not, it can be really, really annoying. Another place this happens, of course, is in the Microsoft Edge browser. A lot of people complain, but without realizing that a lot of what's been pushed in their face can be configured to go away. And that's what I want to do today, is walk through some of the settings that you have in your control to basically make Edge work more like you want it to. So let's go to Windows 11 and fire up Edge. So the default homepage tends to be really, really busy. As you can see that, even though we're blurring it out because it's unrelated and I don't want any random news stuff to show up here, there's a lot of news, there's a lot of advertisements, there's the weather, there's just a whole bunch of stuff. So what we want to do is get rid of a lot of what that is. We'll start by using the settings menu on Edge. Don't be fooled. This gear, which I'll come back to, is about page settings for this specific page. What we want here is the ellipses in the upper right, and then click on settings. In the left-hand column, click on Start, Home, and New Tabs. This allows you to control what you'd like to have happen for each of those situations. For example, when Edge starts. Well, it's currently opening the quote-unquote new tab page. Let's not do that. Let us open to a page we want to be opened when we open up Edge. I'm going to set https://askleo.com. Now, the next time I run Edge, that's the page that's going to show up. Naturally, you're welcome to set your own start page to askleo.com, but more commonly what people do is they will set it to some other potentially news page that they prefer, or google.com or other search engine, because that's what they're going to do first when they fire up their browser. Now, while we're here, what I'd like you to do is also show the home button on the toolbar. I'm going to go ahead and turn that on, and you can see right away that this home icon has showed up on the toolbar. What do we want it to do? Well, we can do the new tab page, again, which we're going to configure here in a minute. I'm going to suggest that that be to a page of your choice. Again, be it askleo.com or google.com or some other. Whenever you hit the home button, that's the page it will go to. It's almost like a super bookmark. This button means this page. Now, let's talk about the new tab page. The new tab page, of course, is what happens when you open a new tab. And I'll just do that here. And you can see it's coming to the very busy startup page that we had to begin with. Let's clean that up. And that's where this icon on the page plays in. We'll go ahead and click on Page Settings, and we're going to make a number of changes. To begin with, we're going to turn Quick Links off. And you can see that that got rid of some stuff. Show the feed. No, I don't want the feed. I don't want the news on my homepage. And while you're here, if you like, you can change your own background or you can turn it off to be a blank page. You can also set up your own theme, but in the interest of basically keeping things as simple as possible, this then is a very simple new tab page. So let's review what we've done. I'm going to close Edge, and now I'm going to start it up again. When I start up Edge, it's opening askleo.com because I configured askleo.com to be the start page. We also have a home button, which will bring me back to askleo.com if I want it to. And if I open up a new tab, I get this very clean, very simple, not very noisy new tab page. And again, the home button, if I want to, will take me to askleo.com. Now, That new tab page, I wish we had more control over it. I really do. However, within Edge, you can't. The options that I've shown you are the options that are available. If you want to do something more, you need to add an extension. Now, there are several extensions available to allow you to customize what the new tab page should be. The one I happen to use is New Tab Changer. You'll find it in the Microsoft Store, or actually in the Edge add-ons store. As it turns out, because I had run this before, it actually is already installed. It's just not configured. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on. There are, of course, options, warnings, etc. So we'll go ahead and say, yep, we understand what the Got It is all about. We'll go ahead and turn it on. Now, New Tab Changer is here. Loads a custom web page or URL in a new tab. That's what we want to have turned on. If we go to Details and then in Extension Options, this is what allows us to set up a new tab page. Now, since I've been using or overusing askleo.com, what I'm going to do instead is use DuckDuckGo just to show you that there are differences here. The left-hand field is one where you can type in or paste in any URL you want. The right hand is actually a drop-down of a bunch of very common things that people might want to use for their new tab. And you can see DuckDuckGo happens to be part of the list. But you can type in any URL that you want. So we'll hit save. So settings have been saved. I'm going to just close a bunch of tabs here so that we know that we are actually starting from scratch. I'm going to hit the plus sign to open a new tab. There we are. DuckDuckGo. Now, you may get a warning after you use this for the very first time that says, hey, Edge noticed that this is not a standard new tab page. Are you sure that this is the page you want? And the answer, of course, is that since, yes, you installed the extension, you configured the page, the answer is going to be yes. But again, it's another safety measure that Edge is trying to prevent unauthorized folks from doing things like changing your homepage or changing your new tab page. So, we've made a lot of changes to Edge. It should feel a little bit more comfortable. It should reduce the feeling of having Microsoft's ecosystem forced on you. It's more personal. It's what you want rather than what Microsoft wants. And perhaps most importantly, the feedback that I get from people, especially on the default homepage, is that it's removing distractions from your screen, hopefully making you a little bit more productive. So, most other browsers have these same kind of features available as well, but Edge itself is actually not that bad a browser. Now you know that you can customize some of its more annoying features to be more what you want, again, rather than what Microsoft wants. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174623. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.